Hi, I am Swarupa Sail, course instructor for Geotechnical Engineering 1. In this presentation, we will go through introduction, tests to find compaction characteristics, and how standard Proctor test is conducted in order to find compaction characteristics. There are various types of loads transferred by the different types of structure. For example, static load, that is the load at rest, is transferred by buildings, towers, etc., which are stationary. Whereas dynamic load is offered by runways, railways, pavements, and machine foundation. We know that there will be movement of railways and vehicles, and also due to operation of machine, there will be dynamic load which will be exerted on the soil. Whereas hydraulic and seepage forces, that is due to movement of or flow of water, will be exerted on dams and canals. So due to construction of dams and canals, there will be exertion of hydraulic and seepage forces on the soil. So the soil on which these structures are constructed need to have good shear strength. There should not be much settlement of soil, and also there should not be seepage of water which would lead to disaster. Various methods to handle soil with poor conditions are: first one is to construct deep foundation, that is nothing but pile foundation if soil is very soft, or redesign structure itself and its foundation. Third one is the soft soil can be removed and refilled over it. And also the soil can be treated by ground improvement techniques. We know that before compaction, the soil will be in loose state with maximum air voids between the particles, and these air voids are either filled with air or water. During compaction, all these air voids diminish, that is, air moves out of the voids due to application of energy. After compaction, all the soil particles come together because of reduced air voids, hence it becomes more dense. Test to find compaction characteristics. Compaction characteristics are OMC and MDD. OMC is optimum moisture content and MDD is maximum dry density. These compaction characteristics are found first by laboratory compaction tests. There are two types of tests. First one is standard Proctor test and second is modified Proctor test. Purpose of laboratory test is to find proper amount of water to be mixed to use when compacting the soil in field and to find its degree of denseness. In field, soil compaction is based on any of the following methods. First one is static, second is kneading, third one is dynamic or impact, and last one is vibration method. Standard Proctor test is done as per IS 2720 part 7 1980. This test is named after R.R. Proctor. He established that compaction is a function of four variables. First one is dry density, second is moisture content, third is compactive effort, and the last one is soil type. Standard Proctor test is conducted using following apparatus. First one is mold. Here we can see a mold of diameter 100 mm and height is 127.3 mm. And this mold has a detachable collar on top and a base plate at bottom. The soil is placed in this mold in three layers. And these soil layers are compacted using a hammer of weight 2.5 kg. And this hammer is dropped on the soil sample from a height of 30 cm. And the number of blows given to each layer of soil will be 25. To begin with, 5 kg of sample is taken in a pan and water of about 4 to 6% is added to it. To begin with, mass of the mold, that is empty mass of the mold, is noted down, that is the mass without collar and base plate. After that, volume V is found out because we know the diameter and height of the mold. So pi r square, that is area into height of the mold, will give us volume of the mold. Later on, soil is placed in three layers. To begin with, first layer is placed and it is compacted using a hammer which falls from a height of 30 cm. And soil has to be compacted evenly. After compacting the soil by giving 25 blows, second layer is placed on it and same procedure is repeated for third soil layer also. After that, collar and base plate is removed and top soil has to be trimmed with the help of straight edge. Note down mass of the soil and mass of the mold to give us the value M1. Mass of the soil can be calculated as M1 minus M, that is mass of soil plus mold minus mass of mold will give us mass of soil. Since we know mass of soil, we will be able to find density of soil as density equal to mass divided by volume. Water content is calculated for the soil sample which is taken from the top. Since we know water content and density, we will be able to find dry density. Dry density is equal to density divided by 1 plus W. And this procedure is repeated for all the trials. By knowing the value of dry density and water content, a graph is plotted to find compaction characteristics. Here we can see a graph of dry density which we found versus water content. For different water contents, we will plot the value of dry density with which we get a curve as shown. The value of maximum density indicates maximum dry density. And the corresponding water content represents OMC, which is nothing but optimum moisture content. Now, if the graph is plotted for dry unit weight versus water content, we get again the same curve. Instead of maximum dry density, we denote here as maximum dry unit weight. And the corresponding water content will be OMC. So these values of gamma D are found using equation gamma D equal to gamma moist divided by 1 plus W, that is bulk unit weight divided by 1 plus W. And gamma moist is found using W divided by V. W is weight of soil sample, which is nothing but mass into acceleration due to gravity. Mass we have already found on the previous slide. So M into G will give us the value of W, and volume of mold is known. So using gamma moist, we will be able to find gamma D, and those can be used to indicate on Y axis. Coming to the principle of compaction, the degree of compaction of soil is measured by its dry unit weight. Initially, water is added to soil to compact it. This water acts as a softening agent or a lubricant on the soil particles. So, the number of particles in unit volume increases. So, here we have considered unit volume wherein the number of particles are more. Hence we say that dry unit weight is more, and dry unit weight increases till a point is reached, that is what is OMC. So in earlier slide we saw that as we went on adding water to the soil sample, dry unit weight increased till it reached maximum dry density. With further addition of water, curve decreases. That is, air voids are replaced by water. Here we can see that the number of particles are less because water pushes all the particles away from each other. Here the volume of soil sample is considered same as that of this, but here we can see that number of soil particles are more and here they are less. The weight of soil solids hence in unit volume gradually decreases. So we say that dry unit weight decreases after OMC, hence the curve decreases. Compaction curve from dry to wet side has four steps. First one is, soil particles absorb water and they become hydrated. Second, water acts as a softening agent, that is lubricant, on the soil particles. Due to this, soil particles rearrange into denser state till OMC is reached. Next, with further addition of water after OMC, water causes the soil to swell as soil now has excess water. Finally, the soil approaches saturation as more water is added. Thank you.